Amongst these vats of water, pipes, and bubbling tubes are some genetic giants.
It's like thoroughbreds, you know? It's like those long lineages of these Kentucky Derby winners that you see out there. We're doing that with bass right here in Texas.
Yes, bass. Texas is known for big ones. And Tom Lang, the director of the Texas Freshwater Fishery Center in Athens, leads the effort to make sure Texas lives up to that reputation.
It absolutely is hardcore fishery science in action.
Those big fish are called lunkers.
So the Sharelunker Program is a program that we've had since 1986, dedicated, working with our anglers, dedicated to making bigger, better bass.
No other state has a program like it, and it all comes down to selective breeding and DNA. Every January, February, and March, female bass are big and filled with eggs. Anyone who catches a bass over 13 pounds during those months can call the Sharelunker Program. Biologists will come to the lake, retrieve the fish, and take it back to Athens for breeding.
And we'll pair it with the offspring of previous Sharelunkers, with male offspring. And so you get a Sharelunker spawning with a Sharelunker. And when you put those two things together, you end up with some really nice big offspring.
Once the Sharelunker eggs hatch and grow a little, they are transferred to outdoor ponds at the fishery center, where they continue to grow until they are big enough to be put back into the lake their mom was caught from, or into other lakes across Texas. The hope is they will grow into Sharelunkers themselves, and if history is any indication, some will.
These are replicas of the top 10 largest largemouth bass ever caught in the state of Texas. State record right up there, over 18 pounds, caught back in 1992 off of Lake Fort. This fish in the middle though, very interesting. Over 16 pounds, caught back in 1988, the ninth Sharelunker ever submitted. A fish that was caught last year on Lake Nacogdoches that set the lake record was over 15 pounds. That fish was determined to be the great, great, great granddaughter of that fish right there. Six generations of Sharelunkers.
It's like the Manning family, but with fins instead of football. If you need more proof the program works, just look at this year. 23 lunkers were turned in, the most since 1995.
We're doing everything that we can at Texas Parks and Wildlife to make the best fishing possible for current and future generations.
And there is a new lake being constructed to do just that, a nursery of sorts for giant bass. And it's a place we've been to before.
So Bodark Lake is the first major reservoir built in the state of Texas in 30 years.
That's Jeff Makito, public relations specialist for the North Texas Municipal Water District, talking to us over a year ago when we first visited Bodark Lake. Back then, this new lake being built outside of Bonham in Fannin County was nothing more than dry land and a vision. But today, a new reservoir is starting to take shape.
We've reached a major milestone in the project, and we're now capturing water. Impoundment has begun, and now it's up to Mother Nature for how long it'll take the lake to fill.
We caught up with Texas Parks and Wildlife at Bodark Lake. They are already stocking Sharelunker offspring into the creeks and ponds that will become the lake once it is full. This will give the lake a head start in growing giant bass. But these fish also need some help.
These pipes weren't just left here by accident. When the lake is full, they're going to be under 20 feet of water, and they'll help create a habitat that'll maintain a healthy population of fish.
And maybe one day, these daughters or granddaughters of past Sharelunkers will make their way back to Athens, repeating the cycle.
And Texas is the big bass capital of the world, and we're going to keep it that way.
In Athens, I'm meteorologist Kyle Roberts.